I would like to welcome you here. This is a celebration of life for my brother, Lester Eugene Sewell, who entered into rest on Wednesday, October the 7th, 2020. Lester's my brother, and I'm very honored and grateful to be here today as we remember him and reflect on his life. It is only natural that we should be sad today, because in all practical sense, Lester's no longer here physically. But the Bible says that's absent from the body is present with the Lord. And if we believe that today, we know he is resting in God's hands. Today is a day for loving memories, a very special day to share together and to rejoice in the gift that God gave us for 63 years. This is one of the hardest things I think I've ever done in my life. Huh. But with God's strength, I know I can do it. And I know you can do it.
Amen.
My brother Joe was supposed to pray, but he's not able to do that today.
Amen.
I hope you understand. So I would like everyone to close their eyes and say your own personal prayer. Y'all know how Lester's bro, right? I know this is going to be hard, but I don't think he would want us to be here in silence. I think my brother would want us to tell a few jokes, because Lester could come up with some things that I have no idea where he came up from. I think mama or grandma dropped him on his head a few times. But in his memory, we have to realize, you know, life is about experiences, and sometimes God stops us just for a minute and makes us think about what tomorrow's going to bring. Did you say I love you to someone that you're supposed to say I love you to? Are you holding a grudge against someone because of something that was done? Life is short. And we've all probably been here before. And I want to honor those people that have done this. The mothers, grandmothers, aunts, uncles, brothers and sisters that we've laid to rest in this place. I want to honor their spirit, because now Lester is one of our ancestors. He is an ancestor. And I wasn't going to say this, but I am. Lester never liked wearing shoes, and he wanted to be comfortable. So if you want to take your shoes off and relax, you can do that. So we're going to have a hymn of comfort from our sister-in-law, Brenda Johnson. If she can come forward, if she's able to. And after Brenda finished singing, we're going to have a niece and a nephew to read the scriptures.
Because they said that Lester always liked to see everybody happy. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to start off by saying, praise the Lord, church.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord, church.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody, praise the Lord with me.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Yes. Very grand. Mm. I'm going to wake him up for you, Lester. Lord.
my hand.
Yes.
And lead me on. Let me stand.
Amen.
I am tired.
Yes.
I am weak.
Yes.
I am worn through the days and through the night. Lead me on to the light. Take my hand.
Yes, Lord.
Precious Lord, and lead me on.
Yes, 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 yes.
When my way
runs
near.
Yes.
Precious Lord, linger near. My life is almost gone. Hear my cry, Lord. Hear my call.
Yes, Lord.
Hold my hand, precious Lord, and lead. Precious Lord,
yes, Lord,
take my hand,
yes, 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 yes,
and lead me on. Let me stand. I am tired. I am weak. Lord, precious Lord, and leave us
alone. Amen. Amen.
I'll be reading Psalms 27, 1 through 6. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked advance against me to devour me, it is my enemies and my foes who will stumble and fall. Though an army besiege me, my heart will not fear. Though war break out against me, even then I will be confident. One thing I ask from the Lord, this only do I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life.
Yes.
To gaze on the beauty of the Lord and to seek him in his temple.
Sorry. For in the day of trouble, he will keep me safe in his dwelling. He will hide me in the shelter of his sacred tent and set me up high upon a rock. Then my head will be exalted above the enemies who surround me. At his sacred tent, I will sacrifice with shouts of joy. I will sing and make music to the Lord. The reading God for people of God.
Amen.
Church.
I'll be reading John 14, verses 1 through 4. Let not your heart be troubled.
Yes.
Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you guys so much. Now, like I said, all week I've been hearing a lot of stories about my brother. And they all made me laugh. Some of them I've never heard. Some of them I've heard before with basically the same information. But now it's your turn. 2 minutes, please. If you get up here and talk too long, I'm going to look at you. But to honor Lester's memory, I think it's fitting that people come and say what they have to say. You're not doing it for us, you're doing it for him. And I'm going to go ahead and open the floor to family and friends to come up and give us your fondest memory of him. And just keep it 2 minutes if you can, please. So, anybody want to start off first?
Come on. Thank you. Awesome. First of all, I give condolences to the family.
Thank you.
From myself and the Johnson family.
Amen.
I didn't come prepared for this today. I wasn't prepared for Lester leaving us.
Amen.
He's a guy, people say that people can be replaced.
Mm.
We can replace the person, but we can't replace Lester.
Mm-hmm.
Lester was a man that helped a lot of hands. Lester had a heart as big as a giant.
Mm-hmm.
And he was just so well loved. I can remember he went with us for 13 years. He went to everybody got Lester to come to help his wife do some cleanup.
Mm-hmm.
13 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
He left everybody's house and came up to the shop because Mike or somebody said, Lester, do this tomorrow. And tomorrow just kept being tomorrow. And he was there until the last day.
Amen.
And every time you turn around now, there's somebody saying, where's Lester?
Mm-hmm.
There's a Lester job that's got to be done. And he was a guy, like his sister said, he was a guy, he was a funny guy. I'll tell you a couple of small jokes. He told me some time ago that he's a bro man that came from the doctor. He said he had a weak heart. I said, okay. So we were digging a hole one day, and I said, man, take a break. I said, because I'm not giving you mouth to mouth. He said, don't worry about the boss, man. Take me to the nearest valve stem. So that was one of the things. And I used to leave Lester in the yard doing work, and I would leave. And Rita would say, my sister Rita would say, Lester, where's Poopy?
Yeah.
He's gone to the other friend, Frederick, because it can't be the same friend, Frederick, because he's been gone too long. The guy just had jokes. And one day he was in the shop. There was a fly flying around, and Lester looked at the fly and said, don't be humming in my ear because I don't know the words either. I mean, this went on day after day. He always had something funny to say. Even when he made me mad, I couldn't stay mad at him because I knew Lester just had a heart. I could be doing something and leave and expect him just to wait that guy back. And he had a saying, got it from Elderly Bright. I'll come back, boss man, done, got it. That meant the job was done. Go to the next one. So he's a guy that's going to be missed. I thought a lot of Lester. I worked with Lester. I did all I could do for Lester. But Lester was a man with a mind and spirit of his own.
Amen.
A mind and spirit of his own. And he would do anything for anybody at any time. Sometimes I thought people just used Lester. But he was there for him. I take him home, here come, boss man, I did so-and-so last night with so-and-so. Then so-and-so came and got me, did so-and-so. But he was a big man with a big heart. So we're going to miss him. Family, if there's anything we can do for you to help out later, just give us a call.
Thank you. All right, y'all, now I'm a problem.
said my brother Lester. I was close to all my brothers growing up. I'm the baby that took care of me. They took care of me. Lester's only brother whipped my tail. He picked me across his lap and he beat my tail. And I was mad at him for a while. Wow. But they all was very instrumental in my life. You know, toward the end, I used to always go down there and just sit down and sometimes talk to him. It was very wise. And very, very wise. Oh man, and like I said, I got one joke. I just have one joke. And I hope I can nail it. I remember Lester was working. He said, called mom, said, hey, go to the store. Can little brother drive me to China? I said, it's okay. So we drive up the road, we go. It's just two parts to this, but so we went in the store. So Lester, he loved pork. He picked up some hug maw, pig feet, pork chops, pig, whatever you name. So we got to the counter, so all of this pork is coming through. And so the lady, the cashier says, oh my goodness, what are you doing with all that pork? That's to say, I'm building a hog.
That sounds like it.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Lester was my first cousin on my father's side, and me and my brother standing back there, water out back there. We remember when we was young, we'd come up to play with Lester all the time and have a good time and stuff like that. And walked in the house with his mother, his grandmother walked in the house. We got in the house and, whew, boy. Y'all got hot in the air. We had to come out the house. We started sweating when we walked in the door. Back in them days, the old folks got, when they got cold, they had to heat cook it, no matter what. It was cooking no matter what. So, and I've known that for a long time. I missed the plane with me. We were young kids. We were all like, I'm 2 years old here. So, back in the childhood time, we had a nice time. Even when my father passed away, Lester was there with him in that time rain, and we all got together and had a little good time down there. But I remember I missed my first cousin for a while on my father's side. Mm-hmm. And I want to thank everybody for being here today. Thank you.
Lester was very close to my dad, Uncle Johnny. I remember him calling me a couple years ago, telling me, your dad then tore up the house. And I was like, a little raggedy house, like, really? He done tore up the house, he done left out of here, nobody knows where he is. What do you mean you don't know where he is? He was like, he done jumped in the car and he done left. And I'm like, what is wrong? He said, he's just not acting right. He done tore the house up. He didn't much you can tear up in that house. But I kept calling him back. Lester kept calling me back. Finally, my dad came home. And Lester said, he's back, but he's out back in the yard. I'm like, doing what? He came back in. He said, daddy got on the phone and said, I went to the post office. Why, I can't go check the mail? You need to let somebody know where you are. You done tore up the house. What is wrong with you? And trying to talk to him, but I appreciated the fact that Lester called me to let me know what was going on with my dad, because then he called me back and said that the cops had came and daddy was outside, they was gonna take him away, and stuff that he was doing, he was had early stages of dementia. But him calling me, let me talk to him, let me calm him down, and I ended up coming down here, going to the hospital with him and everything until they got him transferred. But I thank God, because Lester, you know, I would come down and him and daddy would be in that house, and I'm like, Lord have mercy, can't y'all just move and do something, or let me tear it down or something? But I thank God, because he was my dad's like best friend. That was his like favorite nephew, because he stayed there with him. And I'm gonna miss him. I'm gonna really, well, I know now he's up there with his Uncle Johnny. So they cutting up. Thank you.
I'll be taking care of the acknowledgments and the obituary today. To the family, my family, I want to say that I share in your loss. I love you all, and I'm here for whatever you need. Can everybody see me? Am I too short?
You good,
sis.
You're fine.
Thank you, thank you. A journey remembered. As some people journey through life, they leave footprints wherever they go. Footprints of kindness and love, courage and compassion, humor and inspiration, joy and faith. Even when they are gone, we can still look back and clearly see the trail they left behind. A trail bright with hope that invites us to follow. Praying you'll be comforted with precious memories and God's presence to care for you in your loss. With sympathy, blessings and love to you and the family, William, Ida, Trisha, and Kayla. I think I said that right. In sympathy, the stories of our lives are written moment by moment in how we've loved, in the day-to-day things we've shared, and in the many ways we've touched each other's hearts. May all that you share bring peace in your time of sadness. May God be with you. Love, LaJuan Titus. Dear Sewell family, on behalf of the members and friends of Brooks United Methodist Church in St. Leonard, Maryland, I am sending you our heartfelt condolences as well as our prayers for your comfort and strength. The 15th verse of the 116th Psalm says, "Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints." Brother Lester was not only one of God's precious saints, but he was a child of the King. And on October 7, 2020, he was received by our Heavenly Father with an internal embrace. For the believer at death does not leave the land of the living to go into the land of the dying, but rather leave the land of the dying to go into the land of the living. Death for the saint is the last step of life that leads into the presence of God forever. Remember that in this moment of sorrow and sadness, that a celebration has begun in heaven. For in this very moment, Brother Lester's soul has gone from the toils of this world to the rewards of eternity. From the sorrows of this world to the eternal joys of heaven, from the temporal fellowship of earth to the eternal fellowship in heaven. So I say to you, my brothers and sisters in Christ, what God is saying to Brother Lester Eugene Sewell, well done, thy good and faithful servant, rest from thy working employ, the battle fought, the victory won, enter the master's joy. The Brooks United Methodist Church family is here for you and yours, and we will continue to pray for you and keep you in our thoughts. Yours in his service, Pastor Jason L. Robinson. The family would like to thank all that have showed their love through calls, texts, visits, cards, and other acts of love during our time of bereavement. They would also like to give a special thanks to the Sons of the American Legion, Barbara Damian Hayes, and Sewell Funeral Home. Now, the obituary. Lester Eugene Sewell was born on March 30th, 1957, in Prince Frederick, Maryland, to Marion H.B. Sewell Johnson of St. Leonard, Maryland, and Langford E. Long of Huntingtown, Maryland. Lester was raised by his loving grandmother, Marion Sewell, deceased, in St. Leonard, Maryland. Lester was known by many names: Les Pooh, Pooh, Stickman, Uncle Douglas, and Uncle Pooh. His wife, Ernestine Johnson, preceded him in death, and from this union, he inherited three bonus children: Kathy, Kevin, and Gwen Height. Lester was surrounded by four loving brothers and a sister that loved his wisdom, jokes, and life lessons he shared. His stories brought laughter and light to many family gatherings. Lester was a jack of all trades and worked at several boat companies as a fiberglass boat technician. He also was a top oyster shucker at Denton Oyster House, as well as a heavy equipment operator for Morgan Russell Incorporated. Lastly, he was a dedicated and loyal employee at Brothers Johnson Incorporated. Lester attended segregated schools in Calvert County, Maryland, Brooks Junior High, until schools were integrated. He graduated Calvert High School in 1975. Lester's memory will be cherished by his mother, Marion H.B. Sewell Johnson, brothers Marshall Johnson Sr., William E. Johnson Jr., Brenda, Abel B. Johnson, Mia, Corey L. Johnson I, and sister Corita Johnson Myers, uncles Elijah Sewell and Irvin Long. Also cherishing his memory are his grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and godchildren, Brianna Smith, Peyton Harris, and Dejon Johnson. Lester's memory will also be cherished by a host of family and friends, including special friends, Floyd Height Jr., Clinton Bourne, Langford Johnson, Linwood Scales, Charles Elliott, and Thomas Gross. Amen.
Amen.
So we're going to have a tribute. This service is very unconventional. Most people would say, "Where's the pastor?" Well, if y'all know my brother, he believed in God and he gave his life to Christ, but Lester wasn't a person with a whole lot of pomp and circumstance and keep you too long. So instead of doing that, we decided the best people that know him is us, right? Mm-hmm. How many people have you ever been to a funeral and nothing against my pastor because he's a man of God, but you've been to a funeral and the pastor don't know nothing about the person. So they start preaching to you because he's done his work. And I would be remiss to say that if COVID and things that's gone on haven't changed your life, you need to get your personal relationship with God. So I'm not a pastor, but you have to make a decision on your own. So my daughter's like, come on. So we decided, a few of us, myself and brothers, I told them what to do, actually, written our tributes. So, Marshall, you're going to come first and read your tribute. And Dom, you okay? Yeah. All right.
It's rough getting old. Look at you. Hey, tribute to my brother Lester. I ask myself, can I walk in my brother's shoes? Mm. You know, many times people ask, am I my brother's keeper? Mm. But I say, can I walk in my brother's shoes? Mm. He wore size 11 and a half. Mm. I wear 12, so. Wow. That'd be kind of tight. But to be able to walk in his shoes, first, they have to fit, but you also have to be 100% plus to match his character.
Amen.
That's it. As anyone would tell, anyone you talked to found out that he was very witty, fast on his feet, with any comments, and just kept me in stitches. Things that he would say always had you scratching your head. That's
just never complained about not having anything, but he always gave whatever he had to give.
That's right.
He gave you, if he didn't have it physically, you could talk to him and he would give you the courage to go get it yourself. Can I walk in my brother's shoes? Mm. No. Mm. And I was searching for other words to express my thoughts on Dustin. And one day we was as young kids, we used to run around through the woods at Island Creek. Dustin mm-hmm. wanted to hang out with us. Dustin had on crutches because he had been hit by a car. So Dustin wanted to go hang out with y'all. I'm going in the woods with y'all.
On his crutches.
On his crutches. Well, we got to a barbed wire fence. And we had to cross it. Dustin said, I got these crutches, I'm going to hop over. Well, Dustin had that sock on his foot, and that sock got caught on that barbed wire. Dustin said, Marshall, catch me quick. But then I ran across this poem by David Hawkins, and the poem reads, "He is gone, remember me." You can shed tears that he is gone, or you can smile because he has lived. You can close your eyes and pray that he will come back, or you can open your eyes and see all that he has left. Mm-hmm. Your heart can be empty because you can't see him, or you can be full of the love that you shared. You can turn your back on tomorrow and live yesterday, or you can be happy for tomorrow because of yesterday. You can remember him and only that he is gone, or you can cherish his memories and let it live on. You can cry and close your mind and be empty and turn your back. Or you can do what he would want, smile, open your eyes, love, and go on.
My brother Abel also wrote his tribute, and then I have mine, and then one short one for my mom. Remembering Lester, what can I say about my big brother? Lester was funny. He had a great sense of humor. He loved joking around to get people laughing. Because he was funny, it was only fair he should have the most and most awesome nicknames. Lester was referred to as Stick Man because he was so tall and skinny. His family also lovingly referred to him as Les Pooh. As a kid, I loved playing with Lester. Some of my fondest memories are of us when we were older. Lester would come over and pick us up in his gray Chevy Vega. Anybody know what a Vega is? Okay. And drive us to Grandma's house. Lester sneaked me a taste of Coke 45. Don't tell Mama. Oh, sorry. I miss those times. Thanksgiving and first Sunday family dinners at Mama's house won't be the same because you're not there. We take so much for granted in life. Sometimes we forget to say the things we want to say or do the things we intend to do. I love you, Lester. Things won't be the same without you. Rest in peace. Love, Abel.
Amen.
So the last voicemail I had on my phone was from Lester. He said, "This girl don't ever answer her phone. She ain't my sister." Because when I call her, she said, "This is Karita Myers. She ain't my sister." So I wrote a poem about it. You want to hear it? You joke, she ain't my sister. But let me present the facts.
We are family due to blood, because we are brother and sister because of our love. Our birth certificates read Mother Marion Sewell, which is good. Our life is forever tethered, building our brother and sisterhood. Family photos capture you standing tall, one of six firstborn, elder brother number one. The photos don't truly capture your essence, your jokes, your wisdom. What fun. Key witnesses have firsthand knowledge of our love and respect, but only you and I know the secret smiles that our hearts collect. Expert witness can be called as well, Marshall, William, Abel, Corey, and Mary Sewell. And they will testify about your humanity, compassion, and loyalty. You paid me with trust, wisdom, and feeling like royalty. Exchanging our time, love, and jokes. We even mix a few libations with a little bit of Sprite and Coke. We caught a fish with your lucky rod. You told me it wouldn't be too hard. So under consideration of your grace, Lester, under these facts, I have presented my case. She ain't my sister, may ever be muted. For today, Lester, you are saluted. You are the epitome of a brother. Now, forever, eternally, everlasting, evermore, world without end. Your love has been exposed. I love you. Case closed. So I asked Mom, I'm going to read Mom's story, and she's going to close out, and then we're going to do an interment. Mama wrote two stories. One, she said, once upon a time when Lester was at the tender age of seven, his grandmother and Uncle Elijah took him for a road trip to East Baltimore for a family visit. During the visit, Lester and his cousins decided to walk to the corner store. But on the way back, Lester got separated from his cousins and wasn't discovered until they returned that Lester wasn't with them. Uncle Elijah went out to find Lester and found Lester in the company of the Baltimore City Police. The officer informed Uncle Elijah that he asked Lester, where do you live? And Lester said, not here. Uncle Elijah was so happy that Lester was safe because he could not return to Calvert County without him. But he told Lester, next time you come back to Baltimore, you're going to be on your own. So this is one of my mother's favorite stories. This was some of the last exchanges that Lester and she had. So she says, not long ago on Sunday morning, Lester called me on the phone. When I answered, he said, good morning, sunshine. And I laughed so hard. I said, wow, good morning. She had to share this with me. And she said, Rita, Lester said, good morning, sunshine. I said, well, maybe he thought he was calling his girlfriend. I don't know. So she said later, she asked him, was it a mistake? And he said, no. So to your sunshine.
Amen.
So we're going to follow the direction of the professionals here. And we just ask you to, if you're going to the grave site, to get in your car immediately so we can go there. And also the pallbearers, I need you guys to line up. Okay?
Gardens for the interment. We just
just ask that you from here move to your cars so that we can line up and process over together. Everyone, please stand.